Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University's Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
Okay, so as we just mentioned there, we've been talking pretty much everything about Delta over the last few weeks, but now we've got this Lambda variant coming around. Is that something we need to be concerned about right now?
Well, we need to be concerned about variants in general. And so Lambda first appeared or was identified in Peru. And if anyone's following globally what's happening with the pandemic, Peru had a very, very difficult time with the pandemic and still does. So in the United States, they've identified over 1,000 cases, but we're still just overwhelmed with Delta. 93% of all the new infections supposedly are Delta. And it looks like Lambda is not outcompeting Delta, but it is easier to transmit than the original ones. The vaccines work, but not as good as with the original viruses. So it's a variant of interest, like you said, but it's probably not going to take over in the United States like Delta.
How many of these variants can we expect? I mean, I guess using the flu as an example, how many variants of the flu are there? Is this something where every week we're going to be hearing about a different one and something else we need to be prepared for?
Well, this is the question of the day that you just asked. It's endless. It is going to keep mutating as long as there's a lot of people infected, as long as there's a huge part of the population and in the world that's not vaccinated. And when you have these flare-ups where people refuse to wear masks and socially distance, this is just going to go. It's a broken record. It's going to just continue. And some of the variants are going to be worse and some are not.
I'm sure you're looking at other countries and, looking at some of these reports out of the UK, other countries in Europe where they had these flare-ups with Delta. But then since then, their cases have really dropped. Do you have any optimism about that? If people do the masking and everything, that we could see the same thing happen here relatively soon?
Marcus, good observation. You know, and it's because the United Kingdom is one of the most vaccinated places on earth. They had that huge flare up a couple months ago and they just went all out, gave everybody vaccines, mixed and matched. It didn't matter what it was. They just vaccinated. And I think that's why they're seeing this decrease. And they also, you know, it's a single country with a centralized health system. They don't have like one state or province or region that says, well, we're not gonna wear masks, or we're not gonna do this, or we're not gonna take vaccine. It's a more uniform population.
I'm sorry, doctor. We keep hearing this 1% number, 1% of people who, or fewer than 1% of people who are vaccinated have been having breakthrough infections. Do you think that number is accurate?
Well, I think, you know, if you look at it, at the big picture, it's still just approximately 1%. However, you look at certain very specific areas and it's much higher than that. And I think what you're going to find, I think you're onto something. I think you're going to find that the Delta is so transmissible and is slipping under the immune protection of most of the vaccines that you're going to see more people. But I still believe that the mortality rate is going to hold. In other words, people aren't going to die from this if they're vaccinated.
All right, Dr. Murphy, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We're going to get to some questions later on here on Friday and answer some viewer questions. You can always do those online. Northwestern's University Institute for Global Health Facebook page or our Facebook page at WGNTV.com. Dr. Murphy.